Hello, my name is Kevin Nilsson, and I'm a developer advocate for Google Cast. I'm here to give you a quick overview of the Google Cast iOS SDK. The Google Cast SDK allows you to extend your existing iOS, Android, and Chrome application to a second screen using a Google Cast receiver device, such as a Chromecast. Google Cast enables you to use the familiar controls of your phone, tablet, or browser to control the experience of your application on the big screen. Let's start by looking at the life cycle of an iOS Google Cast Sender application. First, you must scan for devices on your network. Once devices are found, the user can select a device for the device manager to connect to. Once connected, you will launch the application, and finally, after the application is launched, you can begin sending and receiving messages. Now let's look at the cast icon. You should only show the cast icon when cast devices are found on your network. As you can see in this example, when the user clicks the cast icon, you show a list of cast devices that can be connected to. To show a list of devices, you begin by starting the scan of the device scanner. After scanning for a few seconds, you can ask the device scanner for a list of devices on your network. Each device object has attributes such as family name that can be displayed to the user. While scanning, the Device Did Come Online delegate will be called for each device that is found. Keep in mind that you do not need to manually keep track of these devices because the device scanner already maintains a list of devices. You can, however, use the Device Did Come Online delegate callback to trigger refreshing of the device list that you are showing to the user. The cast icon has two primary states, disconnected and connected. When a cast device is connected, you must change the color of the cast icon to be highlighted. The connected state color can be customized to match this color scheme of your application. Here you can see that in the cast video sample application, we chose yellow for the connected state. Also, there's an intermediate state when the cast receiver is connecting, which accommodates the case when a Wi-Fi network is slow. For this state, the Google Cast button appears animated. The waves in the lower left corner of the Google Cast button change progressively to the color of the connected state. To connect to a device, you start by initializing a device manager with the selected device. Now you can connect the device manager. When the device manager connects, the Device Manager Did Connect delegate method is called. Now that you are connected, you can launch your application using the application ID you received from the developer portal. Launching the application will cause the HTML5 receiver app to launch, giving you the 10-foot experience. Once your application is launched, you are ready to send and receive messages. You must subclass Cast Channel to send and receive text messages to your Google Cast receiver. Media Control Channel, a subclass of a Cast Channel, is a convenience class that should be used when controlling media. Now, you should have a clear picture of the lifecycle of a Google Cast application. When you start thinking about adding Google Cast to your application, I recommend reading the design checklist. By following the checklist, your application will follow common user interface patterns that are found across all Google Cast Sender applications, keeping your cast experience simple, intuitive, and predictable. All users benefit when every cast application implements the same patterns. Following these guidelines will help your users avoid pitfalls when using Google Cast. To help you implement the best practices, we have provided a series of checklist items with full descriptions and pictures. You can get more details about the Google Cast SDK at developers.google.com/cast. Don't forget to take a look at the cast design checklist. You can find several example apps at github.com/googlecast. Feel free to post your developer questions to Stack Overflow using Google-Cast. You can also join the Google Cast developers community on Google+ for pro tips and to share your experience. It's now up to you to go and create a great iOS Google Cast Sender. Happy casting.